Everyday people talk about suspension settings to know how to jump or to ride fast. But the braking performance is a key point to your bike efficiency and to your own safety. Sometimes people forget that speed is nothing without control. There is few things that you want to check on your brake before you go riding. The first thing is your lever angle. If you have your lever that are set too low, you will, when you be riding, you will be tightening your handlebar way too much, and you're gonna have problem with your forearm. What you want to have is to have the correct set and having the lever slightly high to be able to have the full pressure of your handlebar coming on the inside of your hand. The second thing after the feeling is the reach. Having the reach correctly set to have the right pressure coming from the end of your finger. If you brake with your main part of the finger, that will be really hard to be progressive. What you want to have maximum progressivity is to have a feeling that is on the outside of the lever and to be able to have the control with the end of your finger. One more thing that you need to check on your brakes before you go riding is your disc dimension. For sure that everyone is setting the bikes with 160 for cross country, 180 millimeter diameter for all mountain and 200 for downhill. But for example, in my career, I've been using in some of the races a 160 millimeter rotor on the rear to get a little less aggressivity on the attack of the brake and get more control of the traction and the wheel, the rear wheel under the braking. That's an example, and to tell you that you definitely need to choose your diameter function of your weight, function of your discipline, and function of your riding style. You will want to choose your brake depending on this, on its quality. Its quality will come from the attack and power of it. The attack is actually the contact that the pad will have with the disc at the first part of the stroke of your lever. This will apply a first part of your of the power of the brake itself, and then the power will increase depending on the pressure you will apply on the lever. This is important to know because this is will bring you a certain progressivity, and that will bring you another control of the traction under braking. Don't forget that you will have to service the brake at least once a year. Replace the fluid and make sure that everything is fine with it. You also want to make sure that you don't put any type of product on the piston and on the lever that could damage the brake. What you want to make sure when you come into a situation of heavy braking is to make sure that you control a maximum traction between your front and your rear wheel. Most of the people, when they brake heavily, they move their weight backward and hit the rear brake really hard. That's when they actually, most of the time, skid from the rear wheel. What you want to have is to realize that you need to load your front wheel and act 70% of your braking on your front brake to really control your direction while you are braking. On the rear wheel, you need to make sure that you have your heel down to when you actually press your brake to really control the feeling and keep the exact motricity for the rotation of your wheel and not skidding and not having the back wheel drifting from one side and the other. Corner coming at you, you want to make sure that you brake ahead of the corner to carry speed in and out of it. But you will also brake in a straight line coming into obstacle, and you need to make sure that you have your braking efficiency, always with anticipation to what's coming ahead of you. On another way, most of the people, when they ride, they actually do a lot of dragging, which means that they keep the brake on pretty much all the way down the downhill. When you drive a car and you go down a mountain pass, most of the situation of the people, when they actually keep their foot on the brake permanently, that's when you actually end up having a brake failure. It's the same thing on a bicycle. If you do a permanent dragging, you will definitely affect your quality of braking. So make sure that you get the momentum ahead of the obstacle to anticipate your braking, but also let it go when it's time after the obstacle or after the corner.
Now that we covered most points about braking, be safe and enjoy your ride.